2006年全美西门子青少年科学技术奖在纽约揭晓，来自俄勒冈州的迪文垂文卓获得了个人组冠军。
来自田纳西州的3S小组获得团体组的冠军，四名华裔学生分别获得团体组季军和第五名，以及个人组的第五名。下面就来看看本台记者袁科的采访报道。迪里垂研究的是量子力学中的数学模型，他的研究成果将来有可能用于弦论和镜面对称的研究理论。团队组的斯科特·莫隆尼、斯蒂文·阿坎吉利和斯科特·洪顿的研究领域是生物工程中的电脑模型。 尽管这些学生都是科学研究领域的高手，他们也都是另有专长。例如，迪里垂是一位钢琴爱好者。They
are the next generation of leaders because leaders are people who really don't just participate in one single area, but they are well-rounded. They are encouraged to get out in the community. So I really have a bright future for these students and ahead of them.
学生们表示，只要努力去调研。 进入这个比赛并不难。
Anybody can be here. Anybody who really wants to put in the time and the effort to do research can.
It's important just to follow what you enjoy and always keep asking questions.
If you put your mind to it, you could do it.
纽约大学校长表示，全国的所有学生应该以这些学生为榜样，发掘自己的潜力，建立他们自己的思维。
Should be inquisitive. They should ask the question why and. And when they hear the explanation, until it makes sense, they should keep asking the question why.
首先要鼓励孩子的好奇心，设法帮助孩子回答问题。另外的话，你如果说你可以说我回答不了的问题，就让他在 Internet 上去找答案。孩子们都很喜欢 Internet， 他找到了答案以后呢，他就觉得他自己发现了一些东西。西门子基金会总裁表示，他们正在在全世界90个国家推行青少年科学技术竞赛。
But there will be Siemens competitions very much like the one we do here in the United States in other countries around the world. And we're excited about that because we do business there, we have our families there, so we're just as interested in the education system as the people that live there because our folks live there.